Well, truly a royal wedding indeed. Beautiful couple, the right crowd, perfect decoration, and truly a colorful occasion. Congratulations to the couple. All right, let's go check out the inaugural dinner held in honor of the governor of Edo State, Mr. Godwin Obaseki.
As the governor of Edo State,
I will discharge my duties.
I will discharge my duties to the best of my ability.
After the inauguration of the new Edo State governor, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, and his deputy, Dr. Philip Shuaibu, the celebration train later in the evening moved to this venue where a well-deserved dinner was held. As expected, it was a dinner night filled with music and dance to welcome Mr. Godwin Obaseki, who was accompanied by his wife, Betsy. The hall was packed and everyone here seemed to be having fun with the new governor and his deputy. Mr. Obaseki took out time to acknowledge guests who have come to honor him. Now it's important to know some of the dignitaries present, and they include the Speaker of the House of Representatives, Honorable Yakubu Dogara, Governor of Lagos State, Akinwumi Ambodi, Forbes Richest Man in Africa, Aliko Dangote, former Governor of Ogun State, Chief Segun Oshoba, Delta State APC Governorship Candidate, Otega Emero, former MD of the Bank of Industry, Ms. Evelyn Oputu, former Delta State Commissioner for Information, Mr. Chikioga, amongst other important personalities.
The people of Edo State identified him as one of the shining stars that will take over from a governor too, that by popular consensus perform creditably well. I knew that they had made a good choice.
We have the continuity that we have always dreamt of in Edo State. I'd like to just firstly say a big thank you to the former governor, Comrade Oshomole, for believing in you and also, you know, urging the rest of us to support him and make this dream happen.
Godwin is a very, very strong at heart, and I have dealt with Godwin for many, many years. I know that he's getting most of his inspiration from somewhere, and I'm going to say it today, from Betsy.
Godwin is professionally able. He is very moral and genuinely intends to do what he wants to do. I must confess, I did worry whether he would have the political skills to become governor of Edo State, but he would not be here now if he did not have those political skills. Godwin, well done.
And to heat up the occasion a bit, Nigerian artist Korede Bello took to the stage to serenade the governor and his guest as he cut the cake.
I don't change my name to Godwin. I don't buy money to Godwin. I say my market no go sell to Godwin. And then we say I don't go to Godwin. Then my brother, make them
And then the governor stepped up to the podium with a speech full of gratitude.
Tonight is the night of gratitude. Gratitude first to God Almighty, because without Him, this would not have been possible. You all knew I didn't seem to stand a chance. I was the last to get into the race. I was reticent. I said, did I really want to expose myself to this? But on inner reflection, I remember and I recall what my mother, she's here, used to say. It's like, if you don't do it, who will? And I remember what she told me many years ago, and I said it this afternoon. She told me, when I was still quite young, after I left university, she said, Godwin, do you realize that you, your generation, you are the last of the old order and the beginning of the new? You are the bridge generation. If you fail, if you guys don't make it, Nigeria will not make it. Because it's those of us who were born just before and immediately after independence that still remember what Nigeria was like. I'm sure the kids who were born after the Civil War have no idea that Nigeria once worked and worked for all of us. So it's our responsibility as a generation to make sure we reestablish that connection.
Mr. Godwin Obaseki and his wife also took out time to honor some distinguished personalities for their support. And it's time to dance as Nigerian veteran musician Sir Victor Waifu ensured there was never a dull moment. No doubt, this is a fun way to kick off his administration before he gets down to the real business of governance and his promise to deliver the dividend of democracy to his people.